whether he had first or bat. Just missed the pad. The bat hit the pad on the way down. Straight onto the bat base.
Yeah, just on the edge of my seat, the way he played that delivery. Glenn Phillips trying to target the pads, target the stumps. Imran Khan playing on his back foot. But he's a good player off the back foot. So he'll be confident in his ability to get bat on ball, Glenn Phillips. Excellent start from Imran Khan, the leg spinner who heals from these parts. Just two from the over so far, one delivery left.
Oh, yeah.
Top class over, 18 without loss. Is back. So is Ish Sodhi. Just one wicket in the tournament so far, 1 for 40 or 4 was the first game he played against the Tridents. He have to be licking his lips at bowling on this Queen's Park oval surface. Up against his Kiwi brethren, Glenn Phillips.
Really important for any bowler that your first over you start well. It's difficult to play catch up thereafter. And certainly from what we've seen so far, all of the bowlers have started well. So you don't want to be that bowler who releases the pressure. You can get into your spell. It's something that I've spoken to Hayden Walsh Jr. about. That first over, where if you get hit for runs, it puts you under so much pressure and you're not allowed to bowl your spell. Just sense, Bish, something's gotta give.
Emirate after it. Surprised that some of the shots that have run into the outfield haven't traveled a little bit faster, given as much sunshine as we've had since play began. This morning, albeit a little bit late. If you're around the Caribbean wondering where you can watch this game, you can download the Sportsmax app and watch CPL for free. Why wouldn't you? Free? Wow, anyway in the Caribbean. That's very pleasant. it really is very pleasant and a nice little glimpse of the ability and talent of Nkrumah Bono.
Yeah, Majestic from Nkrumah Bono here, going over Long Off. When many bands... chest of beverage. I know who would like that. A colleague of mine, I'll leave it as that. How do you assess this start?
It's cautious, isn't it? Cautious start. I think a lot of teams have worked out they need to just find their way in these early overs, get accustomed to the pitch, and once they're set, really up the ante.
Jermaine Blackwood will come in after the end of the Guardian Live Offlane. সাবস্ক্রাইব করেছি ভাই, আজকে 25,000 সাবস্ক্রাইবার হয়েছে, অনেক বড় অ্যাচিভমেন্ট। কিন্তু সবাই আমার সাথে ফেসবুকে কানেক্ট হবেন, এই ফেসবুকে লিংক দিয়ে দিলাম। ইনস্টাগ্রাম কে কে ইউজ করেন একটু হাত তুলে বলেন, ইনস্টাগ্রাম কে কে ইউজ করেন? 29/1, 6.1 of our already gone black hook right now on strike. Hey, what man, kya hoga bhai? Hey, cricket live, bidhar se chala jao. Aapko... Acha. Acha, aami use karan, Rashid Bhai, aami use karan. Okay, aapata jona aami Instagram aar link dichi. Okay, to follow kore diben, na kya?
सभी को बताते हैं यहाँ पर एक बार फिर से गेंदबाजी करने के लिए जो है शुरू हो चुके हैं गेंदबाज, और देखेंगे इस गेंद पर क्या करते हैं एक बार फिर से। और स्ट्राइक पे जो है फिलहाल हो रही है आपको जर्मन ब्लैकवुड, जो कि 5 गेंदों पर अगर हम बात करें 6 रन बनाकर खेल रहे हैं। जी हाँ दोस्तों, 6 रन बनाकर खेल रहे हैं, जिनमें छक्का लगाया था पिछले ओवर में। चलिए देखते हैं जमाएगा क्या करते हैं। और यहाँ पे बल्लेबाज फिर से बढ़िया गेंद,
introduction, Johan Blake, Jamaican sprinter, 100 meters and 200 meters. Very eager Tom Moody to be part of this Talawa's setup.
He showed a bit of promise there, didn't he, with a few back foot drives and front foot drives. Love to see him play. I reckon, put it this way, I think he'll do Blackwood between the wickets. He's about the only person, though. But he's a very, very keen follower and passionate about the game. The delay is because I think the ball has been interfered with, and what I mean by that is the player has accidentally put some saliva on the ball just through habit more than anything else, and once that happens, the third umpire has to come out and use the correct sterilising material to clean the ball up. The player who we're trying to identify who it was, but I think it may have been Emirate, the captain, that put his hand up and said, look, I've done this. Brad Emirate, the captain of the Patriots. This is a home game for the Patriots. Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis. Also a popular tourist destination. City Basseterre, quite enjoyed Frigate Bay. Martinez Peaks. Lovely beaches. The culture is strong here in St. Kitts and Nevis. Affectionately known as Sugar City. Scoring at just over 5 runs per over. Quite slow in the context of T20 cricket. Ryan Emirates will have plans of slowing that even further. So far they've done a really good job in terms of containing boundaries. Two hero maximums in the innings so far for the Talawas. Yeah, it's nearly like they're breaking this innings up in two halves. They're going to be conservative in the first 10 overs and assess their position and then look to the back 10 overs for a minimum. Around 9 per over should give them that competitive total they're looking for.
So the impact of Karan Pollard in the last 7 or 8 overs of that contest with the Knight Riders and the Tridents. Talawas will be hoping for someone in that lower order to play a similar innings. Maybe Carlos Brathwaite or Asif Ali. It's going to be difficult to get yourself set in quick time on this surface. That's cheeky. Very well done. Using the pace, the awareness of knowing the fielder is within the 30-yard circle. Wonderful execution.
Quick on offer. Opening the face of the bat, just giving himself a little bit of room as well. He marches back.
So far from the over. I spoke about batsmen to come. Chadwick Walton will get an opportunity to free himself up. If he gets a chance, might want to improve on that strike rate. definitely clobber the bowling. Sliding down. On move, Joel Wilson. Halfway stage, 53 for one. That is the signal for an Angostura LLB drinks break.
That's it for the Angostura LLB drinks break. Jamaica Tallow was 53 for one. Beautiful afternoon of cricket. Great day so far. Really exciting matchup in the morning between TKR and the Barbados Tridents. TKR maintaining their perfect record for 2020. Them on the top of the table, and here we have the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots at the bottom, desperate for points. Beautifully stroked. That's going to go all the way. That's four runs. Fresh out the break.
White is beautiful. Yeah. Timing for all to see here. Yeah, delightful.
Interesting, Danny, to see the cricket today. I think we could say, as a general rule, all the batsmen have approached the top of the innings with a little more caution.
Yeah, they're getting used to it, and the custom, aren't they? That adjustment there. Now they have to adjust here because you've got Cottrell coming left arm around and changing the angle up. That's the beauty of it. You can't always play on a 22 yards that have got runs written all over them and bash it to all parts. We've been going on about percentages of wickets fallen to spinners at this venue, has a history of it. So you can see why toss that Robin Powell wanted to go up front in the afternoon game, because as you mentioned, Alex, the weather, it's been great, the sun's out, and his belief is that he'll only get a little lower and slower with the fourth innings played on the surface. Cottrell flips.
Just the single there. Great to see Sheldon Cottrell back. He's missed a few games as well.
Just been enlightened. I know you were our intrepid reporter, Alexi Jordan. He had to have a tooth extracted. That's why I missed the last one.
He did, in fact, have a toothache. True story. I know the Patriots fans around the region and world will be glad to see him back. And Andish Sodhi, been a bit unlucky with their players.
Slightly bigger bounder than Warner. The spinners on there at Warner Park can often go the journey. Go the journey here as well. Nowhere's bigger.
I've only had a brief visit to Nevis, Dan. You've never been to St. Kitts?
You've been to Nevis, but not St. Kitts.
You just passed through on the way.
I'm the other way around.
That's us all the way. That's four runs to end the over. Sure, I'm happy with that. After 11, the Talawas 64 for one.
Friendly full toss. Sergeant Cottrell gleefully accepted.
I don't know what's going on there. Blackwood was on his knees. Well, he seems to be all right. Blackwood and Phillips at the crease for the Talawas. Captain's brought himself back. Right, Emirate.
Yeah, that responsibility in terms of a drinks break. So often, keep saying it, it's tumbling after a drinks break. Brad Emery will know that better than most, and here he is. Good opportunity, ball in hand.
Interesting you mentioned, Danny, about the responsibility of the captain. We saw Kieran Pollard, well, for the whole tournament, he's really been leading from the front, but this morning, really, give up captain's knock. You guys log on to dream11.com, pick your team, pick your players, download that app. While you're on there, download the Sportsmax app as well.
Really?
Yeah, you can watch for free around the region. Watch the CPL on your phone, mate.
Hashtag nice one.
Responsibility for a captain, Danny. You have to play well, usually involved in all parts of the games, and then of course you have to be the big brain, the big engine.
And that's why you gleefully accept the extra cash.
Bigger check.
Oh, it's a big one. It's in the air. Ah, safely taken by Ben Dunk. Those fingers feeling a lot better now. Jermaine Blackwood caught in the deep.
Yeah, right idea. Just poor connection and timing is the undoing of Blackwood. Very comfortable in the deep there. He's going to have to whip off that helmet and disappear for 27, and it's now 66 for 2.
Spoke about responsibility of the captain, right? I'm taking a wicket. Asif Ali, the new batsman.
Asif Ali here because now Blackwood used the feet, sweet. Just the contact. What a contact. Ball on blade. And came second.
Ball of the over. And just the one run in it. 69 for 2. Welcome back if you're just joining us. Beautiful day at the Queen's Park Oval. Wonderful to be in the Rainforest Match Centre with Danny Morrison. You missing the beach in St. Kitts, Danny?
I'm missing the beach anywhere. We can't get out. But look, we've just had the Barbados tourist flip on. You and I were wearing our blue. We really did want the Patience to win.
Such a good match today. The St. Kitts and Nevis is what we actually saw, but I'll take it.
Well, then that too. Barbados and now St. Kitts.
Phenomenal match this morning. I hope you guys all caught that match. Exciting. Tough loss for the Barbados Tridents, but what a win for TKR to keep their record 100%. Returning. What have the Patriots got to do, Danny?
Well, in a perfect world, they simply need the 2 points. They've got to win. They've got to find a way to win. The best way of doing that now is certainly knocking over Phillips. He's got a start. Been there for 26 deliveries. It's been a bit of a grind. And it's the confirmation of the 2 points. So this is the battle of the cellar dwellers. Patriots even more so. So, yeah. A couple of wickets back-to-back would be very handy for the Patriots.
Yeah, and if you're a Talawas fan, that Barbados Trident's loss this afternoon worked for you.
That's it, no joke!
Ticking over here.
Just simple, being outrageous, and Phillips, as we know, he can flick the switch and go. And he does score in 360 areas.
Speaking of which, hello, goodbye.
Oh, yeah, here at Maximum again. And that is a go-to area for Glenn Phillips. Footwork precise, muscular, with fast hands. Oh, yeah. Easy as you like. Very impressed with John Ross Jagasar. His flight, subtle variations on the crease.
And it's gone again on the last ball of the over. Someone's underneath it. Take the drops!
Is that Nick Kelly? Nick Kelly has shelled this one. 10 off that over. And the Talawas are 79 for 2 here.
Well, the Talawas let off there, for certain. Asif Ali lives to see another day.
Oh!
Glenn Phillips, should I say, the danger man.
Yeah, it went up a long way. Big, big boundary on the side. Nick Kelly with sunglasses on. Oh, yeah, 9 times out of 10, you'd back yourself to swallow that.
Was casual, Danny?
Well, he was there, covering it. Got there. Massively frustrating for the Patriots. You know, you're in this rut. Everyone goes on about winning. It's a habit. Losing's a habit. And you get stuck.
After a match, Danny, aren't there moments you look back on in the game? A few key moments that can change the game.
Always. But it's a missed run out, drop catch like this. Yeah, he thinks he's out. He's hit it down, and Nick Kelly's in a very good field.
Normal.
It's good for him. It's him there, Kelly back. So we've had 5 dot balls in a row. With Kelly dropping the catch, and now Phillips on 28 from 35. Pressure pumping.
Made an over from Imran Khan. After 14, Talawa 79-2. Wonderful numbers, Imran Khan. 7. Very impressive, Danny.
18 dots, so there you go. 3 overs, not scored off, and you can only bowl 4. It is simply stunning from Imran Khan.
Last over. From Imran Khan, the most economical over of the tournament so far. Spell.
To Jagasar with his challenge to lock horns again with Phillip. Sensing away. Just over 5 overs now. And he's going to have to pick his moment, Glenn Phillips, that is, to really get going. Because he has used up 37 deliveries. Big shout, big shout. Bowler liked it. No one else did. Sodhi tidies up. Get four runs. Bit of wood involved.
Do you get the sense, Danny, that Glenn has had to rethink his innings, considering how the Tallows have started 2020?
Well, a lot of us have been saying it, Alex, that you have to assess what's out in front of you. This pitch is certainly the lower, slower side. Different, the 22 yards yesterday in the morning game, gripped massively with the moisture. This one's a little bit dry and a little bit slow as well, but you have to work hard. There's no doubt about it. You've got to dig in, grind, and as the players have been saying, almost play like a 50 over innings. Get yourself in, get set, give yourself a chance. Only 1-4 and 1-6 to Phillips in this innings to date.
Ball of the over. And he's chosen that one to go for. Has he got all of it? Yep. It's the hero maximum.
Yeah, it's a biggie, isn't it? What a beauty. 12 off, 15 done, 91 for 2.
Sodhi has to be now an acceleration. The progress so far has just been about a runner ball, and even given for the nature of the surface, With 8 wickets in hand, the Talawas will definitely want to put their foot on the gas with that to come. Chadwick Walton, Robman Powell, Carlos Brathwaite, etc. In the air, Evan Lewis is underneath it. Evan Lewis takes it. So the pressure has told. And he slowly strikes.
As mentioned, very difficult to get a start, to time the ball. Asif Ali plays some lusty blows. Attempting another hero maximum. Evan Lewis gets in the way. Gone for 14 from 10, 92 for 3.
Talawas captain has strolled to the crease. He's not on strike. He's at the non-striker's end. Could be a couple. Is a couple.
This was wicket of Asif Ali getting deep in his crease. Got the elevation, didn't have the power to go over the fence. Slowness of the pace on that delivery, outdoing him.
That's him now!
Down the ground, in the gap. Good cooperation between Ben Dunk and Sheldon Cottrell. So Darren Ganga, they've done, I suppose the Patriots will accept the work they've done so far. Look at the use of the bowlers. I'll come back to you in the next over as to how they use their resources to ensure they finish clinically.
One.
Spinners have completed their quarters. Sodhi's finish, 97 for 3, 16 gone. It's wonderful to see Imran Khan, 36-year-old local lad, shouldn't say lad, local man, come in and do so well. 1 for 7 off his 4 overs today. Jagasa has finished as well. And so is Ish Sodhi. That is an outstanding spell following his 3 wickets last game. Jagasa has been good all the way through after missing the opening encounter. Sodhi, a good performance today, 1 for 27.
To respond to Ian, I felt Red Emirates did a very good job collectively at the start of the innings. If you look at the first six overs, just two boundaries conceded, one hero maximum, 1-4. So what he did, he used the mystery of John Ross Jagasaw with the new ball to restrict boundary scoring and set the tone for the innings, which was quite good. Cotterell, usually someone who bowls in the power play overs, did exceptionally well. You spoke about Imran Khan following up that. I guess the Talawas played to their hand as well, because they were much more conservative in their batting approach. Eldorado Sky Cam taking flight.
And the Talawas innings needs to take off as well. Hope Shellan Cottrell is okay. He was on his haunches there for a little while. He seemed to have some discomfort in the leg. Surely you would see Phillips standing well outside leg stump, attempt to get under throttle. Yeah, that is the attempt to get things going with no deep third man.
Innovation clearly required on this surface. Trying to use the pace from Cotterell and outdo the field set by Riyad Emirates. Two fielders within that 30-yard circle through the offside.
Now he's well across the stumps. And goes down the ground, goes big. He's been lining this up. And the foot has been pressed on the accelerator, Glenn Phillips.
The luxury of being there from the start. He's sucked up a lot of deliveries, Glenn Phillips. He knows it's important to go deep. And he's got to accelerate. There's no better way to do so than this. Hero maximum down the ground. Cotterell trying to make the accommodation and get Fuller.
Struggling with something.
Cotterell missed the last game. Understand he had an extraction to do. So he had a visit to the dentist. Maybe the effects of that extraction just weighing on Cotterell. Vital for the Patriots at this stage of the innings for him to complete his complement of four overs. After this, I'm sure Emirates will want to bowl him in that final over that he has in a complement of four.
They've lost the original ball down underneath the expanse of covers. That's where the ground staff park all the tarpaulin after they've removed it from the playing surface. So it's obviously rolled into one of the folds of the coverage. So replacement ball has been taken. Emirates not happy.
Three wicket support so far in the innings. Imran Khan getting the wicket of Nkrumah Bonner. And then Jermaine Blackwood attempting a hero maximum just didn't get the power. So to Hudson Bali. Holding out in the deep mid-wicket fence. And then Lewis, the fielder.
I'm eager to see the start of the Patriots innings with Chris Lynn coming out again, and whether it will be Mujeeb and Sandeep, but it'll be Mujeeb and someone with pace off the ball, you would think, early at Chris Lynn. Every time this tournament, he's been out to spin. Trying to take pace off with Cottrell. He tried to. Phillips has hit back-to-back sixes here at the Oval.
He's so strong, Glenn Phillips. Off the front foot, off the back foot. Finds that muscle. Muscles really matter. Just tugging it wide of long on.
He's one though, Glenn Phillips. I think you can try two things, and Cottrell is going back over the wicket, so he can try one to bowl in his legs, Phillips is strong on side, or definitely one you can go full and wide to if you can get the wide Yorker in. Goes wide with base off the ball, and Phillips down the ground. It's a welcome 50 for the Jamaica Talawas, and that is a celebration, El Dorado style. Three sixes in a row.
Very good players in T20 cricket. They find a way to accelerate. He wasn't striking at 100 for a major part of his innings. And now all of a sudden, he's striking at 117. Excellent knock. 117 for three.
That was the slowest half century in CPL 2020 and the slowest in CPL for Glenn Phillips, who's been prolific in years past. Rothman Powell on strike. That's high. That could be out. Ish Sodhi. In fact, Jagisar comes around and takes it quite easily. Powell fails again. He would be distraught at that.
Indeed, this will just stifle the acceleration that the Talawas would expect at this stage of the innings. Riyad Emrit with his cutters yet again taking pace off the ball, staying close. Jagisar making no mistake. That's an important wicket for the Patriots. He's gone for one, 117 for four.
Carlos Brathwaite at the crease, Glenn Phillips on strike. Not giving Phillips any room.
It's been the order of the day for the right-hand bowlers to the right-hand batsmen. Bowling wicket to wicket. Finding that good in-between length. Having the appropriate field as well, protection through the leg side. Imran Khan was very similar. One wicket, just conceding 8 runs.
How good is it on height? How good is it on angle?
Surely there were doubts there. That's why umpire Joel Wilson wasn't convinced. Height and the angle as well, going down the leg side.
A little disappointed with that, the length and the line that Cottrell bowled in that last over to Phillips. I'll tell you why. He has gone into overdrive. He started slowly, Glenn Phillips, remember that. And now he's just flown to 61 from 49 deliveries.
You can tell what type of player he is, Glenn Phillips, recognizing the importance of him scoring runs in this Talawas team. He's taken a lot more time at the start of his innings, the most vulnerable period. Didn't mind striking at under 100, but now he's got the confidence to play his shots.
I think Cottrell used what his skills with the best judgment. A couple of slower deliveries disappeared down the ground. Your maximum race now has Pollard and Phillips on top, the two P's. Standing that far outside leg stump, you've got to utilize the wide yorker at it. Make Phillips reach for it. Well, I think that sums up a lack of confidence and a deterioration in the ability of Carlos Brathwaite. He's making no impression here for the Talawas. Excellence from Riyad Emrit.
That is as soft as you will get. Carlos Brathwaite, simple delivery to defend. That bat nowhere close to the line of that ball. That's embarrassing, quite frankly. Such a talented player, Carlos. Goes without scoring, 126 for 5.
With Walden coming in at 7. What a dramatic drop from opening the batting. Scored all of about 13 runs so far in this Hero CPL. Right, Cottrell, this is important. Important to get this right to support your captain, who's doing brilliantly at the other end. Surely too high. Surely too high. No ball, free hit.
A rarity. Haven't seen many of this in Hero CPL 2020. Cottrell searching for that yorker. Gets it wrong. Phillips not interested in taking a single. He wants strike. Correct decision though.
Perhaps what he was searching for, the ball before.
Competitiveness of this Talawas total hinge on the bat of Glenn Phillips. 62 from 52. Can we see a turnaround in form from Chadwick Walton? He has an opportunity, a license to take the attack to Cotterell.
Dismissal of Carlos Brathwaite, his biggest game. Certainly his batting has gone to pieces. If not his bowling. How far outside leg stump he is. Surely he can't reach a wide yoke. Surely. And you still bowl it into his legs.
Glenn Phillips should be in your Dream 11 team. Up on that Dream 11 Fantasy League. Make the right choices. Move on to dream11.com. Download the app.
Phillips well outside leg stump. I suppose it comes down to a bowler and what he's comfortable bowling. Not everyone is comfortable with his skill in delivering a wide yorker. Not everyone is comfortable with a slower ball. So it comes down to really what you are confident in bowling.
Fact that there are two fielders within the 30-yard circle behind point on the offside. It's pushing Cotterell to stay close in line to Glenn Phillips.
Just there, it wasn't what you'd call a wide yorker, but it was certainly, let's say, fifth or sixth down. And Phillips barely got to it. And that's why I'm advocating, unless he jumps across the stumps before you deliver, that sort of thing lines where you want to bowl to him. Oh, Chadwick, it hasn't worked for you. Up the order, down the order. All credit belongs to Sheldon Cotterell. The salute was a bit becalmed.
And you can understand why. Patriots would clearly know of the form of Chadwick Walton. Yet again, doesn't make a big impact with the bat. Worrying signs for the Tallowers. Walton, that body language not looking good. Gone for one, 132 for six.
Thirty-two for six, the final over. Phillips has been in such good striking form in the last few overs. Because your worst case scenario is to somehow give him one, get him off strike, if not getting him out. The gap. Comes back for two, so he retains strike.
Chadwick Walton premeditating, setting himself. Didn't make any contact. That's a risk that you run when you try a shot like this. And the line of the delivery is wicket to wicket. All credit to Cotterell. He got the length right.
Cottrell. Cottrell underneath it, but he can only watch as it sails over his head. Glenn Phillips is fighting a lone battle for Vitalawaz out there.
A lot of respectability to this Vitalawaz score. 140 now. Makes it look very easy. It's not an easy shot to play. The power, the timing, superb.
Just want to see one wide yorker, and I can go have some crunch. See what I'm talking about? Why would you consistently be bowling into the zone, the hitting area of a gentleman who's so strong down the ground or leg side? He's struggling as well.
It's a very hot evening here at the Queen's Park Oval. Look at the effort of Glenn Phillips to get to, recognizing the importance of keeping strike.
Again, wide of the stumps works for Phillips, who's standing now an off stump. And he is struggling as well. Goodness gracious. He is pulling in some big ones.
Can he get his team to 150? Be looking at that target.
It's unfortunate. There's nothing you can do about that if you're Riyad Emirates. That's the inside half of the bat, and it's sped away for four. And Phillips is down.
He's gasping, out of breath. Symbolic of his commitment to the cause for this Vitalawaz team. Pushing his body to the line. He's down, but not out.
I'd have to get a respirator for him by the time he's ready to leave the field. Scored 100 against the Patriots back in 2018 at Providence Stadium in Guyana. 87 against them last year.
Come on, Riyad.
80 against them in 2018 in the US. He manages to get down the other end to get a single, a leg by off the last ball of the innings, and he certainly must be applauded, Glenn Phillips. He's watched the chaos all around him at times, started slowly, picked up speed, and propelled his team to 147 for six off 20 overs. Is it enough? Time will tell.
He stood tall, Glenn Phillips, in this innings. Again, showing the consistency with the bat for the Vitalawaz. A masterclass in terms of how he's assessed the conditions, how he's been able to deal with the pressure of wickets falling around him. Ideal in the circumstances for the Vitalawaz. There's a lot of hope for the Vitalawaz bowlers in this target.
It's one less than the Tridents got earlier. Gosh, I feel for it. It looks painful walking off here. He has left everything out in the middle and duly applauded by his team. Now we look towards the Lin Spin Showdown.
Glenn Phillips unbeaten at the end of 20 overs, 79 from 61. Wonderful to see the acceleration throughout his innings. Got some support from Jermaine Blackwood, who was the second top scorer, 27 from 26. But still, a lot of concern with the Vitalawaz batting.
That why these two teams are at the foot of the table. That partnership of 38 with Blackwood. A concern as well, Blackwood keeps chipping in with these little 15s and 20s. Not going on. Emrick good again. 3 for 32 off his 4 overs. Look at Imran Khan. 1 for 7 off his 4. Jagasar, tidy enough. None for 32 off his 4. And Isodi, 1 for 27. So the spinners and Emrick doing an excellent job. Cottrell, more expensive than he would have liked. It is warm. That's why we've got Alex Jordan down there.
Hi, guys. I'm with Imran Khan, who must be a happy camper this afternoon. Incredible figures. 1 for 7 off his 4. Imran, it's the most economical spell of the 2020 Hero CPL. Tell me how you're feeling.
Yeah, first of all, I'd like to say thanks to the Almighty. Without him, nothing is possible. You know, it's a good feeling, you know, always doing something good for the team, you know, to put the team in a good position, and hopefully we can carry on.
Your team has had their struggles, and we know Ish Sodhi's been out with injury. So how much more important was it for you to perform today?
Yeah, I think it was important. You know, Ish struggling a bit, but I think he came back well this game as well. But it's all about, you know, taking the chances when you get them. You know, another opportunity and another chance to, you know, showcase my talent, and that's the most I can do.
Indeed, and it really needed to be done today. Of course, the Patriots need all the good performances they can get. 147 on the board. How do you feel about that number?
I think it's a pretty good score on the pitch. I think it gave them about 15 runs too much, but I think along the bat and click, I think we should be able to get over the line.
Well, you know what the conditions are like out there. Any advice you would have for your batsmen?
Just play each ball as merit, you know, choose the correct one, set out the park, and, you know, keep rotating the strike, most important.
Imran Khan, congrats on a great spell.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's our Imran Khan. Bright sunshine. Let's have a look at the Digicel highlights bundle. Talawa's decided to bat first today. Very rare in Hero CPL. And Nkrumah Bonner looked in good touch. To be fair, the last two or three games. But Imran Khan struck. And Sheldon Cottrell holding on to that catch. Jermaine Blackwood then came in. And he started lofting it down the ground. He's looked promising, Blackwood, so far in this year's tournament without getting a big one. While Glenn Phillips started slowly, as we mentioned before, it was the back of the innings where he picked up. Blackwood attempting to go down the ground was well held.
38 was the partnership with Blackwood and Phillips that followed the opening partnership of 28. All along, Glenn Phillips, he stood tall, just anchoring the innings, albeit with a slow pace. But he was setting himself for something bigger at the end. Wicket to fall yet again. That brought Rob McPaul to the crease. And he felt that the captain had to make an impact with the bat in the absence of Andre Russell. That was not to be. He top edge one. And John Ross Jagasam making no mistake. Riyad Emrit used his bowlers quite nicely, and he himself was excellent. He knocked back the stump of Carlos Brathwaite, and then Cottrell accounted for Chadwick Walton, whose horror form continues in Hero CPL 2020. Glenn Phillips found some power in the end and got them up to 147 for 6.
Broad shoulders, Glenn Phillips. He's manfully carried this team, and that's why he sits atop the Dream 11 Fantasy League scoreboard. Riyad Emrit just below him. Emrit has been good all through this year with the ball, led from the front. Imran Khan, good since he's come in. So we're embarking now on the Bet Daily innings break. Don't go too far away. Lynn versus Spin coming up, as the Patriots need 148 to win.
Jamaica Talawa is winning it to us and electing to bat. And it's been pretty much a solo effort with the bat. That man, Glenn Phillips, magnificent, unbeaten 79 of 61 deliveries. And they seem to have been in some pain as well, but real commitment and power and class from the Kiwi international. On March 18, he had the Queen's Park Oval. That's confirmation of that scorecard. Blackwood got to 27. Good partnership with Phillips. Asif Ali, the other one, to get into double figures along with Bonner. The bowlers, Imran Khan, very economical, 1 for 7 off his 4. A wicket for Cottrell and Ishsodi, and 3 for Captain Riyad Emery. Means, therefore, that the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots, they will need to get 148 for victory. The Republic Bank fan question of the day comes from Troy Henderson, Hendrickson.
So, Mr. Commentator, is Ivan Lewis key to the Patriots getting into the Final Four?
A very good question there from Troy Hendrickson. Tom Moody in commentary with me. Ivan Lewis, how crucial is he, not only in this match here, but for the Patriots to get into the playoffs?
Well, there's no doubt he's a key figure, but if the Patriots are relying on one player, it's a real concern. I think they need all their players to lift and perform at their best. Lewis is key because he's a destructive player and he's a real match winner, but he needs Lynn at the other end to fire a shot or two. We know what he's capable of doing, and others in that batting order to all make a contribution to get on some winning ways.
Yes, Ali, almost single-handedly win that contest. The only match that they've won, getting to an 89 here at the Queen's Park Oval. 9 sixes in that innings. So very crucial at the top. The match partner for today's contest, Sat Sports. St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots being the home team in this contest. A beautiful part of the world, Eastern Caribbean, cloud-shrouded mountains, natural flora and fauna, beautiful and idyllic beaches, a wonderful culture, cuisine, and warm and friendly people. So lots to do in St. Kitts and Nevis, Federation of Nevis, the small of the two islands. But really a beautiful destination. And one of the most idyllic in the Caribbean Sea, of the Caribbean islands. So much to do. So much to see. Absolute beauty. Chris Lynn, as we would have expected at the top, loves to take full strike as well. Hasn't had the best of tournaments this year, but he's such a powerful striker of the ball. If he can get going, he would want to get set first, want to get a start. Spin has been very effective against him, so I won't be too surprised if they open with spin. Kyron Powell, in a strange move, opens the batting alongside him. So no Ivan Lewis at the top. I'm not too sure what's the reason for that, but I'm certainly surprised. So he might have been struggling a little bit in the field, hence the elevation of Kyron Powell. Yeah, just having perhaps some groin problems, which is a bit of a concern for the Patriots. Good. So beautiful conditions here at the Queen's Park Oval once again as we get set for this run chase. Peter Edwards is charged with the responsibility of the first over. Play says umpire Joel Wilson, and we're all set. Searching for that outswing, Fidel Edwards. What do you make of this run chase, Tom Moody?
Well, it's certainly within reach. There's no question of that, but it's going to require a smart approach. And we've seen teams that have conserved wickets early on and just built a strong base without sort of focusing on trying to go too crazy in the early overs have prospered. So I think the Patriots will need to have a similar approach. Lynn's away behind square. He should pick up at least two. I'm not saying that the likes of Lynn, who are natural ball strikers, to go completely in their shell. Just read the game. You know, if it's there to hit, by all means, put it away for four or six. But just read the game and be prepared to sit in the game for a long period of time. It's been a lean time for Lynn, but one positive is that there's a number of starts there. So he's threatened on a number of occasions.
There he goes. Just on cue, as you were mentioning, loves pace on, gets pace on, and gets a hero maximum.
It's a brave shot, have to say, because it wasn't right in the slot. He just trusted his eye and trusted his bat swing. Clubs it over straight mid on.
I was just about to ask you, I know that Fidel Edwards has got a wicket with his first delivery against the Guyana Amazon Warriors, cleaning up Brandon King. Would you have been tempted to bowl that first over off spin to Chris Lynn?
Would have been interesting if he took the first ball, if that was the case.
Clean him up. That outswing from Fidel Edwards. What a way to respond.
Puts hit the middle peg. Just a little bit of movement. It was a full pitch delivery, so Lynn will be walking back puzzled to how he's missed that. If anything, it looks like he's just sort of wafted across the line instead of hitting it back from where it came from, which would have been probably the case with an informed Chris Lynn, but we haven't seen that yet. Lynn goes for eight. It's 8 for 1.
Early success for the Jamaica Tallawas. Once again, that man, Fidel Edwards, striking quite early. Dennis Ramden is a new batsman for the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots. Fidel Edwards as well, having played with and against him on so many occasions. But a simply sensational delivery from the veteran to get rid of Chris Lynn. And exactly what they needed, early breakthrough. Fidel Edwards provided that. Good bit of feeling. Certainly saved the boundary. And That's what you need in the field. You need that to back you up. Look at this delivery. Look at the late swing. Playing totally around that one. Chris Lynn. And middle peg goes back. When it's not going your way, it's not going your way, Chris Lynn. Eventful first over comes to an end. The Patriots 11 for 1. Early wicket down for the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots. Not for the first time in this tournament. Chris Lynn once again not able to contribute significantly. Kyron Powell, his first opportunity at the top of the order in Hero CPL 2020. But this man, it's not his first opportunity with a new ball. Mujib, 12 wickets, that leading wicket taker in Hero CPL 2020. Tom, if we could look at the way Phillips played. He was 37 of 45. And then that acceleration towards the back end, 42 of his last 16 balls. What is the lesson in there? What is the message that can be taken from that?
I think there's 2 points to that. I think firstly, he was lucky to dig himself out of a hole. I think he was a little bit behind, more behind the game than he would have ideally liked. I think at that point, a runner ball is certainly acceptable, but he fell way behind. And if anything, he put his team and himself under extreme pressure. And if it wasn't for his perfection at the back end and his ability to hit sixes as he did, those three in a row off Sheldon Cottrell, the incidences like that, it would have ended up being nearly not a match losing innings, but would have been an innings that would have put the rest of the team under enormous pressure because he soaked up so much time. So the outcome, brilliant. But the strategy, high risk.
Yes, I conclude. It would have been a different ball game if he wasn't able hit those sixes towards the back end, having used up all of those deliveries. And this man Mujib, with all of his variations, with all of his guile, is going to be very tricky on the surface. We saw Imran Khan earlier bowling his four overs for just 7 runs as the most economical spell in this year's edition. And a big shot for LBW down the pitch. Kyron Powell, that would have saved him. And then 13 for one after two.
Many batsmen are trying to find a way to combat the brilliance of Mujib. He's puzzled a lot of people with his tricks and his change of pace and angles. And at the moment, there hasn't been an answer. Are we going to see one today?
Fidel Edwards replaced from the media center end by Vasami Pumol. He has performed this role quite regularly over the years. And so he's quite adept at bowling the new ball. He's bowling to the right-handed Dinesh Ramdin. And typically left-hand orthodox bowlers favor bowling towards right-handed batsmen. But I'll be very intrigued to see the way Dinesh Ramdin approaches this inning. He's someone who, like I mentioned before, has all of that experience. And he has that ability to rotate strike quite well, which is very crucial in this run chase. And just like that. Might go all the way. Chase is on. Yes, it does go all the way, despite the best effort of Sandeep Lamichani there. So off the bat, badly lined. This is what he's so good at, and this is what they'll need. They'll need him to anchor that innings. He's batting in that crucial number three position. Sandeep Lamichani here, desperate effort in vain, but commitment certainly.
Random's got to be careful because he doesn't have the finishing power that we saw Phillips have in the first innings, so he can't afford to get too far behind the game. He needs to be remaining at least a runner ball, and then try to move his strike rate into that 130 range. And if he could do that and occupy the crease for a good period of time, just allows the Patriots to settle in for this chase.
And then he also has to consider Evan Lewis and what's his status. We're not too sure what exactly is wrong with him. Such a crucial member of this team, Evan Lewis. But we've seen certainly in today's matches, the first one and then this one, a concerted effort by the batting team to get a start, to get a feel of the pitch, to understand the conditions before they play those big shots. One ball left in the over, Tom, so I suppose you'd come back to the answer to this question in the next over. When you're chasing a score like this, a middling score, what is the required run rate that you would be looking or comfortable with maintaining throughout this chase? Eight runs off of that boom all over at the end of three. 21 for one.
Just to pick up on your question about the run rate you want to maintain, I think a lot depends on the surface you're playing and the attack that you're playing against. Certainly, in the case of today's match, you want to be very mindful of run outs for one. I tell you what, that's going to be tight. Going to have a look upstairs. I think he may have just made his ground. Mull doing the outfielding, getting a good throw in over the top. He's in pitcher and he's over the line, I think. Yep, he's going to be good. So you want to be mindful of that. So you know, they need to manage both Mujib, his overs, and also Sandeep Lamichana, his overs. So manage them and try to get at least run a ball off those guys. And the three bowlers remaining, or the bowlers that make up the rest of the allocation, you need to target those bowlers and try to make sure you're putting them under enormous pressure in pursuit of the total. You don't want it to go beyond, I would have thought, in this match situation, beyond 8.5, maximum 9 and over towards the back end, because it would be very difficult to achieve. Not every team's got a Coram Pollard in the lineup.
Yeah, you don't want to get yourself in a situation where you need a boundary in the over. If you can manage seven without taking any unnecessary risks, then you should be fine. But if it balloons towards that nine and over mark, where you might need it to get a boundary every over, then it becomes problematic. So these initial overs, very important. Wickets in hand, as we know, always important as well. It's all about finding that balance, finding a way to rotate the strike, to negate the threats of the main bowlers, and staying in the contest. He's dropped him. Asif Ali towards his left, unable to hold on. Should have taken that one, you would feel. The end of four overs, 26 for one.
Looking to lift it over cover and not getting the timing. Asif Ali just moving slowly, one would have thought, to his left and not getting in a strong enough balanced position to be able to complete the catch.
Kieran Powell surviving that opportunity of the final ball of the last over, lives to fight another day. Man from the island of St. Kitts, Kieran Powell. This one is lofted over the top. Might not have the legs to get to the boundary. They just really pushed this one. Wasn't looking for the hero maximum. Showing some intent against the left-handed Wissami Pomor. Can't find the gap, Kieran Powell. 9 from 13 to the fifth over.
Sloppy picks up an easy second throw at the bowler's end. No one was in position. Throw was poor and it's enabled them to pick up a much needed two. Just looking at the leg side field to Powell, the square mid wicket is very straight. There's a mid on, so the sweep is on. Big appeal and it's not given. They have just been tracking down the leg side.
Yeah, Wissami Pomor wouldn't agree with you. He would think that this was going straight on. Huge shout, not given. Joel Wilson wasn't convinced. And he is the man who needs to be convinced. Just mentioning about that fielder. He's very straight. Kieran Powell getting much squarer. So he did start in pursuit of this total from the St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots. Single to end the fifth at the end of 5, 33 for one.
that play is just about done and dusted. The Kitson Nevis Patriots. A little bit of work on their hands, given the nature of the surface, and they've lost Chris Lynn. Yeah, pal. Oh, nearly out to Carlos. Chin up, as they say. Confidence is such a big part of sport, certainly in cricket. Swapped ends here is Fidel Edwards. Very tall, athletic figure of Carlos Brathwaite. Couldn't get down and get there. Would have been great for the Tullowars. And straight. Just a pinch one though. Righty-o, let's go side on to Alex Jordan.
Hi guys, I'm with Stuart Williams, the batting coach for the Patriots. Stuart, your thoughts so far on this chase?
We're 35 for one, chasing 140. So our plan is just, you know, for 1 hour batters to bat deep in the innings.
Speaking of one of your batters, no sign yet of Evan Lewis. Is he all right?
The last over of our when we were bowling, he had a slight brain injury, so we're going to assess him in another couple of minutes, 10-15 minutes.
Okay, so that's sort of a fluid situation.
Yes.
It has been a bit of a challenge for your top order so far in this competition. Having said that, that's a nice 4 runs there. To what do you attribute it?
Well, you know, we were in lockdown for a couple of weeks in preparation. You know, having said that, you know, we still have a tournament to play, so, you know, we could try our best. We had probably 1.5 net session because of the weather. Not an excuse, but it's reality. But, you know, we're still in the middle of a tournament, so still trying our best.
Is it additionally challenging for you as a coach to not have a fixed lineup yet and feel comfortable in it, in the top order?
Well, I mean, this is T20 cricket, and we always said the team that gel quicker, as soon as, you know, going to hit the ground running early as possible. But, you know, we had to try one or two combinations. We're missing a couple of guys because of injury and other stuff, you know. We'd have been like to have Fabian Allen here with us, but he's not here. You know, so like I said, we have to try different combinations.
The region must be happy to see Kyron Powell playing cricket again. What's it been like having him in the camp?
Of course, like I said, for me, he's an opportunity. You know, he's one of the better players in the Caribbean. Definitely. So, like I said, I hope he make use of this opportunity now. And
good, luck
first.
Good luck. Good luck.
No problem. Thanks, Alex.
Thank you, Alex Chan. Just see for the lead, which is a frustration about things. The wouldn't have liked being pumped back over his head, but it was a delightful stroke from Powell. 38 years young, fit individual, and to keep going to do this job, it's a great effort. Always been in the gun-slinging fraternity. Low on the clock with the arm. It's nice and straight. Very good line. End of the Guardian Life power play. It's 39 for one. FedEx fastest deliveries of this hero CPL of the whole tournament. These numbers, and these gentlemen, Hossein Thomas. There. Speed merchants. Oh, the Jamaicans. Not going to play, but he's very, very quick indeed. And he gets it right. Rhythm is flowing. And he is is rather tasty in the pace department. Ian Bishop alongside, we've got our friend Carlos. He needs to get into a groove himself.
Power play signal with a smile from Joel Wilson. Blackwood failed to pick up initially, and Sandy Blamishane is going to come on, I would assume, shortly. And Randin has played spin relatively well over his career. Kyran Powell as well is someone they look to if both are still there, and they need to still be there when he comes on to be able to negotiate what he brings to the table. You identify within your batting lineup who are the good players of spin, because you know that will have a big impact on the outcome of the contest. Mujeeb has already had a couple of overs. So it needs to be smart cricket. Powell and Ramdin need to think ahead as well.
It's been a real hallmark of this 8th edition CPL with spinners, wrist spinners, and we've got the South Africans who couldn't fulfill their duties coming here to Hero CPL 8. And it allowed other players to come in and fill the void. And Mohammad Nabi getting a crack, Mitch Santner coming along, all these other young stars. Ajib and Lamachani. Rashid Khan, well, he's one of your first pick, of course, but he too was part of all of the mystery spin fraternity. Very exciting, very challenging in these conditions to try and get on top of. One man who did today play in his own backyard was Kyran Pollard, player of the match. Stunning 72 off 28, 9 maximums and 2 fours. Pollard, he took the contest by the scruff of the neck and did the job. And one of these two hang in and do what Glenn Phillips did when he was out there in the centre. Powell, great opportunity because he's nicely set here. Brathwaite looking around his field. It's got Rodman Powell, the skipper, at long on to the left-handed Powell. I'm just going to have a little look here and want to change things. So Ahmed Chani's going to go back to third man on the fence. Square legs on the fence. Extra cover is out on the boundary as well. Now Carlos Brathwaite wants another man back at long off. So long in and long off. A little change up to finish the seventh. And the Patriots are 42 for one. Dennis Ramden. He's almost going out to run a ball. He's happy to play second fiddle to Powell. Today's match partner, Sats Sport. www.satsport.com. Dear Olsen, Kitson, Nevis. Frigate Bay. Then over the hill. The wild blue yonder. And let's get to Shipwreck. A couple of other bars out there. Here we are in Port of Spain, though, in 2020. Asking right now is just clocked on over to 8.1. Oh, there's a big tickle, it is. Ramden, who's such a good player of spin, has to go straight away in this one.
Good for the Talawas, not good for the Patriots. As you've said, Danny, reputed to be one of their versatile batsmen who had been focused on playing the spin well. Instead, he goes and falls to the spin. 13 to Ramden, 42 for 2.
The other half of the Australian brothers, Ben Dunk. That strike rate up, it has been rather challenging for middle order players in this eighth edition. The pitches that have been provided so far. Let's put a flight. It is just that little flick of the outside edge. Unlucky 13 for Dennis Ramden. Oh, well, well. Fall of the wicket. Rodman Powell is passionate plea from his players. Gentlemen, please, let's step it up again. Dunk, another versatile player. Very useful in spin and pace. Wonderful with some cheeky little improvised strokes. Another 360 player. Can he bat through? Only 75 deliveries left in match 18. And therein lies the challenge for Patriots. I'm trying to track it down. Good call, good response from the Aussie. Love that gun. Oh, too, but he's too great. Even with a fumble. Oh, that put slick. 8 done, 45 for 2. Lynn didn't last long, 6 and out. He ended up with 8. Powell is opening. Buddy is still there. Here's our bit fan of the match. Lennox from Kingston.
No way out here. Fight out the match. Feeling good. Yeah.
Let off.
Champion.
He's watching on the Sports Max watch party. US 500. To Lennox.
Feeling good.
Send in your videos using the hashtag CPLFan and you could be a winner as well. Well done, Lennox. In Kingston. He's not quite ready here. Ben Dunkey's now got a helmet on to over his head. No, oh, there's another one. Dunk's got to go. He's chopped it on. And it's another one down for the Patriots.
Van Dunk's reaction says it all. It's not short enough to play that pull shot. And in many ways, you look back at this as an unforced error. Failure to get any initiative into the knock. He goes for 2, 45 for 3.
Nick Kelly is out in the middle now, number 5, for the Patriots, and a little milestone for Carlos Brathwaite. His 50th CPL wicket in his career, and he's the 10th bowler to do so. Well done, Carlos. Is that the lift? Is that the nice little uppercut for confidence? Nice line and length there. You're mentioning Ishii. Batting and the way he got out, you could just see his head down and his body language was so down when he got out to Raed Emerit. Hope this helps.
Sure. Talawas need that lift, 50 wickets for him in his Hero CPL T20 career. Breathe, Nick Kelly, breathe.
Banged in. Yeah, deep breaths, as you say, Ian Bishop. Midships. Somewhat uncomfortable. the back leg. That's Mr. Pad too.
Yeah, but it's not only that. You're looking at the Patriots, and it's 6 runs off the last 16 deliveries. That's not good enough. 6 off 16, and there's been no great mystery being bowled to them. He's not on Mujeeb. Lamishan is not in the attack yet. Six off 17.
The 26th dot ball in this innings. As you say, Bish, not good enough. Mentioned at the halfway, you've got to rotate. Got to rotate the strike. Too many of these. 9 done, it's 45 for 3.